Kenya, 2.5 million people rely on tea production for their livelihoods. Being located at the equator, tea can only be grown at high altitudes around the country, as it requires cool temperatures. If temperatures rise by 2 degrees due to climate change, in let's say 50 years, there might hardly be any more tea growing areas left in Kenya. And at the same time, tea processing itself requires a lot of energy. So therefore, we are working with Kenya's largest tea company, KTDA, to increase the energy efficiency of their 68 tea factories. With success, some factories already use up to 40% less energy than before. So far, the project has saved 10,000 tons of CO2 equivalent and $13.5 million in energy costs. Hence, the project can be considered a direct contribution to Kenya's NDC. The project allows for the factory staff to learn through training and exchange trips to other factories how they can save energy in their daily work. Because a lot of energy is actually lost in everyday operations. For example, when wet firewood is used in the boilers to dry the tea. The improved energy efficiency has already saved 1.3 million trees from deforestation because the factories now need less firewood for the wood boilers. In some factories, measuring systems are already monitoring energy consumption, and as a result, there are fewer temperature fluctuations in the process, which can lead to higher tea quality and thus to higher prices on the world market, which of course benefits the tea farmers at the end. These results are an example of how Kenya contributes to global climate protection. I hope that Kenya's tea sector will be a role model for other countries.